wasn't too rough on you, was it? That was okay, right? Well, one more thing. I almost forgot. So as I was working on this presentation and going back on all the reflections about Thom and his career, it hit me, you know, this story would make, you know, a really interesting play. But then with Thom, I'm like, no, it would be an awesome musical. Right? I agree. So, I've been working on the opening number to a new Broadway musical paying tribute to the life of Thom Hannum, right? Anyone want to hear it?
Yeah!
All right. So let me set the stage here. So first I'm going to need some help. I need to have the Thom Hannum Chorus come up and join me, please. The Thom Hannum Chorus. So, the way this is going to work is this piece is going to tell the story. Come on and get your mic. This is gonna, piece is going to tell the story of Thom in about 3 minutes and 53 seconds. And to do this, each member of the chorus represents a different group of people in Tom's life. And some of them I'm sure that you will recognize. So we've got, first we have Jack Mellish. Jack represents Colin McNutt and Nick Angelus and Chris Lee and all of Thom's former students, right? Then we have Aaron Roesselet. Aaron represents Michael Klesch and Jim Prime and all, and he embodies all the people that have written with Thom over the years. And then we have Justin Schindler. Justin Schindler represents George Parks and Tim Anderson and all those who have worked with Thom in one way, shape, or another. And then we have Melissa Cron in the role of Linda Hannum. And Natalie Morrison in the role of Marge Dickman. And they both represent the one that made this all possible, Stella Hannum, in essence representing the three women in Thom's life who actually loved him. Right, and me, well, I'm the guy that was with Thom and left him and had a front row seat for 40 plus years to see all the shenanigans. So that is the setup, and I'm going to change instruments here. There we go. Can you hear me now? Oh, good. So, also helping me put this together, I want to thank Keith Paul. I want to thank Tim for his help in organizing things. I want to help thank the folks at the UMass Band for bringing in and helping audio and everything else. So just one other thing we're going to check. Test, test, test. We want to make sure that the audio is going to work. So you want to just hit it and see, make sure it works. Okay, crank it up. Crank it up. A little shifting up here. All right, you ready? Sure? Hit it, Chris. How does a parkside hookhead from a Polish mother, raised with two siblings with an English-Irish father, a Catholic school bowler from a life of blue collar, grow up to be a world champion Tony-winning scholar? For him to be a marching percussion founding father, he got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being a self-starter in his teens. He's drumming up a storm with boys lots older. And every day he practiced hard so he could make the snare line. Marching with the crossman, faces painted thin and hairline. Drum step, twist,
just giving him a chance. In the next 4 years, he'd show how he's advanced.
Well, the cadets, they came a calling, and now excellence reigned. Creative juices burst and innovation not before seen came. Drummers running crazy, making music just the same. Concert instruments on football fields, man, that's really strange.
Well, the word got around, they said this dude is insane, man. His drum lines are the best, and did you hear those mad arrangements? Enter UMass school and don't forget from whence you came. And the world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man?
Thomas P. Hannum. My name is Thomas P. Hannum. There's a million half times I've done. Don't be late. Don't be late.
Marching cymbals and the role they should play when he crashes and sings and all the many sounds they make.
People thought he's crazy, even some threw shade.
George Parks gave him new challenges and watched his lies with pride. He had his office in Old Chapel and Linda there by his side. He's teaching drums and pep band
and marimbas cause he could.
Pretty soon the campus was a buzz. You know, this dude's more than good.
Well, he started gaining stature as he elevates his game, designing drums and sticks and cymbals, writing books in his own name. High percussion, world titles, and Broadway gold were his to claim. He sits with legends in the Crossman Connects, drunk or halls of fame. Prominence with every passing year, they're marching bases, roses, and grenades for everyone to hear. Simple trophy, not them, is the best band in the land. You see it, UMass, you can be a new man.
UMass, you can be a new man.
I wrote with him.
Me, I taught with him.
Me, I loved him.
And me, I'm the damn fool who left him.